What's up, guys? Welcome back to Keto Rewind. I'm Jess, and today's video is going to be about my keto staples, my keto pantry staples, things that I keep in the house all the time. And a lot of these items will also be useful because it will be the same stuff that I'll be using for the Clean 30 Challenge for the month of January. So I thought I'd take you a quick tour through the cooking oils that I use, the sweeteners, the supplements, the veggies, the condiments, all that, just to let you know what I keep in my pantry to do my keto. So anyways, I'm gonna flip the camera around. We'll start off and try to keep this a little bit more organized here. I was pulling stuff out of my fridge, so. We will start with, I guess, my dairy that I keep in the stock at all times. So obviously a block of cream cheese goes a long ways. I don't use it too much for the challenge this month, but I always do, being someone who follows a ketogenic lifestyle, cream cheese. Kerrygold, this goes without saying. I go through pounds and pounds and pounds of the Kerrygold butter. My preferred cheese to use is Parmesan. So I'll do a grated cheese and a shredded cheese. That's pretty much my main cheese that I will be using for the whole month of January in the Clean 30 Challenge. Because it's an aged cheese and it's better for you. So heavy whipping cream is also a staple. Right now it's been really hard to get heavy cream because everybody is using it for the holidays. So you can't be picky and choosy on brand. So right now, the only brand they had in the store. So heavy whipping cream, sour cream is great to make. I make my own ranch dressings. I'll use it for breakfast tacos and stuff like that. For the Clean 30 Challenge, I'm not gonna use too much, but I do keep that in the house. It's nice to be able to cook up my own ranch. So that's basically the dairy. Let's move on to the breakfast and lunch meats. When you see bacon in my videos, I love this from Costco. It's an uncured Canadian bacon by Jones. I buy one of these packages a week. I mean, it's from Costco, so it's a good deal. It's high in protein, it's a leaner fat, leaner ham, I should say. And I swear by Canadian bacon. It's easy to cook. And the other thing I'll do is these sausage links from Peterson's. I think that's how you say it. I get this at Sprouts. They're no sugar added. They're delicious. So when I'm making up my eggs and bacon or eggs and breakfast meats, I'll use either Canadian bacon, sausage links, and I also have this right now for on the go. It's not the best brand, just the Costco brand, but it's already cooked. And if I'm busy or I need to do something real quick, I keep this in the house. But I also make my own bacon. It's real easy to do. You just get a pork belly, and that's a whole nother video content in itself. But this way I know what's in my bacon. Eggs are also kind of out of stock right now. It's the stores with the crazies through the holidays. So I normally get the Alfresco Farms brand. It's a black box, but hey, you got to get what you can get. So I always have at least 24 eggs in my fridge. So this is an 18 pack and I have two of them. But eggs. It's like the most perfect food on the ketogenic lifestyle. Let's talk about pickles. Actually, we'll save the vegetables for the end, but pickle juice and pickles, these are my favorite ones. I get them at Costco as well. They're just dill pickle chips. They're not sweetened. If you are feeling low and sluggish, one of the cheap ways to get electrolytes in is to sip on some pickle juice or some pink salt, pink Himalayan sea salt. I buy it bulk because we use it as our main salt. So I will use pink Himalayan sea salt as a way to get my electrolytes in. I season all of my food with the pink salt. It will help you feel amazing. So I definitely recommend having dill pickled chips and pink salt in your pantry. And then because this is kind of dairy, we're going to go ahead and cover this now. This is also from Costco. It's a real clean, see if I can get the camera to focus. Real clean ingredients, no soy. So that's one of the main things I like this pesto. So I like to make a lot of chicken and stuff and use this as a easy meal prep, just using a store-bought pesto. You can make your own, but this one is pretty much tastes just like the one I would make anyways. So, and it's already ready to go. So I love having pesto, and it's a great way to add flavor. Okay, so speaking of flavor, let's talk condiments. Salsa. I love salsa. We switch between all kinds of salsa. Just read the back. This one here is just a plain salsa. I like it hot. So definitely keep salsa in. It tastes great on eggs. It tastes great on chicken. You can put it on anything as a, just a big boost to your flavor. And the next thing is sugar-free ketchup. I have a recipe on my website that with where you can make your own sugar-free ketchup, but this is a good one to keep in the house. It's no sugar added. It's just tomatoes, real clean ingredients. So check, keep a no sugar added ketchup for those times you're making meatloaf or something that needs a dip of ketchup. My go-to burger topping is mustard. I've converted myself from mayo. So I put yellow mustard on anything. I'll put it on, I'll dip lunch meats to hamburgers, to turkey burgers, steak. I put mustard on everything. It's almost like a free ingredient. There's like really not much to, ooh, I can't get the camera to me. There we go. There's real, very few ingredients in ketchup. So definitely keep that in. Hot sauce is another great way to boost flavor without boosting calories and carbs and all this stuff. So I like to put hot sauce on everything. And you can see we're at a dangerously low level of sriracha. So those are both great items that you can spice up. Eggs, chicken, and stir fries. Speaking of stir fry, I keep coconut aminos. This is a soy sauce alternative. It's made out of coconut. So make sure you read your labels. There's no sugar. A little higher in carbs, but when you make it, you don't use a lot of it. So it's no big deal, in my opinion. So that's condiments that I keep. Let's talk fats. Oop, this is not a fat. So my primary go-to cooking oil for everything is avocado oil. This one, if you've seen Thomas DeLauer's video on quality avocado oil, this is one of the brands that came through a flying color. So you can get it at Costco in this size bottle, or your local stores probably have it in a smaller size. I cook with it. It's the healthiest oil to cook with. It has a real high smoke point. So you will see me using avocado oil to roast all my veggies and do all my cooking. I will also occasionally use coconut oil. This is another great one. I get it at Costco. It is awesome, doesn't have the coconut flavor, just a plain, good, healthy fat. And then when I'm doing salad dressings and drizzles, I use extra virgin olive oil. So I don't cook with it, but I do finish with it, if that makes sense, because it has a lower smoke point. So you're gonna wanna have this more in a salad dressing or as a drizzle on top of something that you finished cooking. So those are my main cooking fats. And then as for spaghetti sauce, this is my favorite spaghetti sauce. Rao's makes a good one as well, but you can get a better value, a larger jar of it from Costco. It has no sugar at all. It's just real clean ingredients, and it's my go-to favorite spaghetti sauce to keep on hand. And with that being said, we'll also talk about apple cider vinegar. Another way to get electrolytes, to regulate blood sugar, to help with your gut, you want to include apple cider vinegar in your diet. I have a recipe for an apple cider vinegar tonic. It's basically water, 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar, 1 teaspoon of lemon, and a pinch of pink Himalayan sea salt. And you just drink that down, and man, does that make you feel so much better. It usually helps with hunger and overall stabilizing your blood sugar. So now let's talk snacks. Pumpkin seeds. I absolutely love pumpkin seeds as my go-to. 1/4 cup of pumpkin seeds is enormous. So you can snack, you can get the crunch. I'll put them in my salads. I'll just snack on them. They're high in magnesium, protein, zinc, and iron. All good ways to get those vitamins inside you. I also make my own roasted pecans. I just put butter on these and roast them in my oven, butter and pink salt. So when I say roasted nuts, I make my own. You can get 2 pounds really inexpensively at Costco. But nuts are pricey, so definitely shop around. And if you don't have a Costco and you have a friend that goes to Costco, have them order these up for you. And speaking of Costco, these macadamia nuts are also a good snack. They're nice and clean, and I'll alternate between my homemade nuts and then some store-bought nuts. But primarily, my go-to nut is a pecan. But I do love macadamia nuts on a salad, on, you know, in a snack. And then another snack to get my iodine in is seaweed snacks. These literally, my kids like will suck these down in a day. They are obsessed with these. So these are great snack all around. They are they're just premium roasted with sea salt. I find them at Sprouts in a 6-pack, but you can find them anywhere. Next thing, let's talk about veggies. Okay, so when it comes to vegetables, I keep this stuff in my freezer at all times. I do buy several veggies fresh, but I like to buy frozen because you can get a better deal on it. It stays fresher longer, and it's just easier to buy frozen because it's very expensive to throw away produce. So I keep this stuff all the time in my freezer. So we'll start off with riced cauliflower. I buy this one from Costco. You can get it anywhere. There's several bags individually bagged in here, so it makes it real easy and quick and easy to steam up a side of riced cauliflower. So a lot of my recipes in the Clean 30 will be using riced cauliflower. Now you can make your own with a head of cauliflower and you just chop it up. But to save some time, I'm a busy mom. We go ahead and buy frozen and keep it in the freezer. You can get any type of stir fry like medley. I don't mind my kids having carrots, so my husband and I, you know, we'll have the broccoli and the cauliflower, but the kids will enjoy the carrots. But I will use this for my stir fry. So it's a great way to get some inexpensive, already diced up, easy to count the macros, because if you look on the back here, when you scan the barcode down here, this will load automatically in your food diary. And all you'll need to do is adjust your serving amount. So it's really easy to log your macros when you use something that is in a package and it's still, you know, a single ingredient. It's not loaded with a bunch of stuff. It's just produce. Same thing with the broccoli florets. Again, if you wanted to easily enter in your serving size for what you ate that day, all you do is scan the barcode and put how much you've had. It also will give you a guideline of how much to have. So when I make steamed cauliflower for myself, I'll double that. So I'll give myself 2 servings as a guideline. Typically when I make when I'm preparing my food, how much to pull out and weigh and measure. So this way I know I'm getting the correct amount and it's easy to track. Green beans are great as well. Again, Costco, again, the same thing, scan the barcode and you are good to go. And then dog photobomb. And then the next one, I like to do these when I'm making stir fries. You just throw that in. If you had some red sauce, you could make a spaghetti. They're just good to have in the house. You can shred your own zucchini, but this is what I keep in my freezer. So I have it on hand if I don't have fresh. And then the last thing, this is not frozen, but it's I'm considering it a vegetable. I guess it's technically a fruit. I like guacamole as a great topping. Like when I, instead of using mayo, I'll use guacamole on my hamburgers and turkey burgers. I'll put it on my eggs. It's great to have that in stock because sometimes when you're using a whole avocado, you never know if it's going to be ripe enough or it's going to be spoiled. So it's nice to have some guacamole on hand, and this one's pretty clean. So let's talk about meats next. Okay, so when it comes to meat, I'll start with the ground beef. Ground beef, I keep this in stock at all times. It's from Costco. Again, if you want to log stuff with your macros, all you would do is scan the barcode or search for it in your food diary and mark how much you've had. So these are, I think, a 1 1/3 pound individually wrapped, but I'll keep these on hand at all times. I love it. If I'm in a hurry, these are also from Costco. They are grass-fed 1/3 pound beef patties. These are awesome. I'll put them on the grill frozen. They're already portioned out, so if I'm busy and on the run, this is like a no-brainer for me. Easily seasoned and cook them up on the grill pretty quickly. And it was pretty affordable. So I put them on the grill frozen. Again, you can scan the barcode if you want to log in a burger into your food diary. Along the same lines, we have chicken breast. I keep breasts or tenderloins in my freezer at all times. You can pull out a pound. I think each package is roughly a pound, so it makes it real easy. Again, you can scan the barcode. And when you see meats, sorry, it's frozen, so we're steaming up here. When you see buy one, get one free, stock up. This is just top sirloin from my local store. I grab them as, you know, buy one, get one free is a pretty good deal. So I like to, my go-to for steak is top sirloin, and I like to put like a butter sauce, like an herb butter sauce on the top, and it's just my go-to. But you can do a ribeye if you want a higher fat content. But these are pretty tender. Remember I told you I make my own bacon. If I don't have a package of this defrosted and cooked up, I'll use the stuff that I showed you earlier in the video. That's just pretty much already cooked. Or this is the stuff we've made and cured it on our own. It was like a 2-week process. There's a bunch of videos out there on how to make your own bacon, but definitely worth the investment. It's way cheaper to make your own bacon, and you know there's no sugar. And lastly for meat, a whole chicken. You can make bone broth out of this. You can make so much out of one whole chicken. It's something that I keep on hand, and we will use those all the time to make everything chicken. And I don't have the ground chicken or ground turkey on hand because, we've used them up and it's through the holidays, but I will also keep ground chicken, ground turkey, and ground beef, for instance. So ground beef, I'd use about an 85-15 fat to protein ratio. For the ground chicken, I'll just get ground chicken. If you get ground chicken breast, I feel like it's just drier. So I like to get ground chicken for both ground chicken and ground turkey, not the breast. I know a lot of people say that's not as healthy, but that's what I do. So, and lastly, let's talk supplements. So when I have trouble hitting my protein, or if I'm hungry and want a snack, or I've done an extra workout, I will use a Quip's protein powder. I also use Perfect Keto's, but I prefer the Quip taste-wise over the Perfect Keto protein powder. It is a whey protein powder, but it's super clean and tasty. So this is vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry, and that's my go-to for a protein drink. And I'll put it with unflavored vanilla or just plain unsweetened almond milk, and I'll do about 10 ounces of almond milk to a scoop of the protein powder. Now, I do prefer the unflavored whey, and I cook with this. I'll use it for baked goods. I'll use it to make my own keto bread. That'll be in some of the recipes that'll be, I think, next week. But this will help you make your own bread in the microwave. And it's nice and clean ingredients, grass-fed, that thing. So use the link down below if you want to try it out and use my 20% off coupon. As for supplements, what I take every day, when I'm fasting, I will take a supplement in a pill form. Not sweetened, and easy to get your electrolytes in. These are also Perfect Keto. And I tell you a million times, I do not go a day without my unflavored collagen. I put this in my coffee and I do one scoop a day no matter what. And then this is something I take every single day, D3 plus K2. The K2 helps enhance the D3, so you're getting maximum effects. So if you're looking for a good supplement, I get these off of Amazon. And I take 10,000 of these a day. I take 10,000 international units of it a day, or two of these, in other words. And lastly, if I need a dessert, my absolute favorite treat that's keto is a peanut butter keto cookie. They come in a 2-pack, and they're 2 net carbs per cookie. They're amazing. They satisfy, and that would be my one dessert that we will have on the clean 30. And look who I found here.
She left the door open.
That concludes my pantry tour of the keto staples that I keep on a regular basis. Do you have anything you want to add for you?
You've done the collagen, right? And the supplements. And did you go over the vanilla milk?
Yes.
Yeah. Or the almond
milk. Almond milk.
I've heard that a lot of people really like the cashew milk.
Cashew milk?
It's richer. But I've not...
I love almonds,
though. I've never tried it, but that's just what things that I've heard and things that I want to try is the cashew milk.
Alrighty. Well, also, I guess when it comes to the vegetables, I forgot to add, I also keep asparagus, but I like fresh asparagus. I don't like frozen, so I buy fresh asparagus. I do buy fresh broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, all of that. But I'm just saying what I keep in my pantry at all times that's frozen. So
one other thing you keep is the peppers and onions already cut up.
Yes.
If you want to do a quick stir fry, you take a handful. It's good in eggs. You can make little, for the girls,
topping on a burger
with some shredded chicken.
Tops of burgers.
Tops of your burgers, and you can just quickly stir.
And it's already diced up.
Yeah.
It's quick and easy.
Oh, yeah.
And if you're going to pan fry it anyways, what's the difference between if you're going to use fresh or frozen? So save your money, get the freshness, and go for frozen. And keto's not cheap, so save where you can. So I save a lot of money by using frozen vegetables versus fresh. And
one other tip. When it's just my husband and I, obviously a bag this size could like last a year.
No,
it wouldn't last a year. But this is 5.5 pounds of vegetables. If you have like one of those vacuum pack machines, I have that.
Food saver.
I take these and I actually vacuum pack them in sizes for just my husband and I.
Mm-hmm, yeah, because proportionate.
The more air you, like every time you open this bag and close it, okay, the more air, which creates moisture, which gives freezer burn, so you're gonna degrade the quality of the vegetable. So I do it right off the bat. There is no degradation. It comes right out of the freezer and it's just enough for two of us. So if you have like a family of three, do whatever your three people mm-hmm. eat in a bag.
Save the time.
And the only thing is when you stack it, it uses up space, but before you put it in there, make it nice and flat, and then they'll stack like perfectly. You can look at my freezer, like this shelf has, I do that. Yeah.
It's nice and flat, stores in the freezer
and
real
stores,
easy.
Stores, you can get so much in your freezer. But that's just a little tip that we do because sometimes there's just two of us. Not very often, but sometimes there is just two of us. It's usually cooking for six, yeah.
All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have a keto pantry staple that you keep in your fridge or freezer or pantry at all times, comment below.
Always looking for something new.
Yes, let's all learn together. So I am going to go hop off and make the How to Track Your Macros video, and I'll see you later. I'm Jess.
Who are you? I'm Deb, Mom.
And we'll see you later. Bye-bye.
Bye.